الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين صلى الله عليه وسلم محمد وعلى اصحابه اجمعين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وانعم وعظم وكرم على سيدنا وحبيبنا وطبيبنا وشفعنا وقائدنا وقرة عيننا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Beautiful ayat that Sidi Qari Umar and Sidi Tayyib recited. I'm going to talk today about the Surah Al-Ahzab, which is the last surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started with it, with the beginning, telling us there is only, you have only one heart. You don't have two hearts in your, inside you. ما جعل الله قلبين في جوفه. If you have two hearts, you can make one for dunya and one for akhirah. But you only have one. That's why. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told the Sahaba, "أحبوا الله بكل قلوبكم من كل قلبكم." كما قال مصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم, "Love Allah with all your heart." Heart is not a place to love anything besides Allah, because Allah doesn't accept any partner. That's why he said, "You have only one heart in your chest." And then he moved, telling all of us and telling the Sahaba that the one who is taking care of you more than yourself is Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم وأزواجه أمهاتكم. أمهاتكم أمهاتهم. Allah is telling us that he is the one, your wali, more than yourself. In Qadir Iyad, in the book Shifa, he said there is a qira'a shadda. It's not from the qira'at. In between the Nabi Ulam min anfusihim wa huwa walidun lahum wa kama qala Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he is their father. Their wife, they are the mothers, and he is the father. So he's the one who is taking care of us. That's why you know that. Why the, all the prophets, they wish to be from this ummah? Because the best care is ever coming from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then you move to the Surah Al-Ahzab, which is the battle of the trench. For days and nights, fear comes to the Sahaba. You know, several miles that they need to protect, and there are thousands from the other side. They cannot go and eat, make wudu, do all of this, and at night it's very cold and wind and so on. So Allah wants to expose the munafiqeen and to show the belief of the believers. The munafiqeen said, "Go back to your home." And Allah didn't describe him that there's people of Medina. He said, "Ya ahla Yathrib." Yathrib is a jahili, it's not the name of Medina anymore. If you say Yathrib now, it's a sin. That's what scholars they say. Allah said in the Quran, "Ya ahla Yathrib, go back." And they went, they left. And they said, "What is the promise that Allah promised that victory? What type of victory? Look, we're in a miserable situation." While the believer, zadahum iman, their belief increased more and more. قالوا هذا ما وعد الله ورسوله وصدق الله ورسوله. And then Allah told us in that surah that Allah sent soldiers that you don't see, جنود لم تروها, send the wind and a fear and all of this, and everything flipped upside down and became that they win everything over that, and they got a lot of things that they win in that day. So this is to expose the munafiqin and show the house, the strength that the Sahaba they have because of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Salatul Witr, inshaAllah.